guys. You got in front of us.
Can't play your door, Cole.
Go back! Run it. Go.
Gotta have a man, Brad.
Right, get on the flyer now. Push up, Luke, push up.
Berkey, Henry, Berkey.
Here, off to the change. Next year, Pounce.
Come back, mate, come back.
Hold on.
Kersey.
Give us some hard drive, Kersey.
Thank you. Yes, guys, and congratulations to Keith and Brad. Well done. I'd now like to hand the microphone over to Mr. Jim May, the president of the Western Border Football League. We will announce the individual medal winners from each side.
Thanks, Graham. Just before I do that, I'd also like to congratulate the Geelong District Football League for the way that they played today. Absolutely terrific, guys, and the way you played that second half, really credit to you, and I'm sure you're not very far away from having a number of wins in interleague football. So well done and congratulations. And I'd like to call number 23, Nathan Lovell, forward to collect the medal for the round. And the winner from the Western Border is Brad Wilson. With that, ladies and gentlemen, the only final thing that I'd like to do is congratulate the umpires on the way they've conducted themselves today, treating every guys, and really appreciate that you're coming down here and doing what you've done today. Thanks very much for that. And with that, I'd like to invite everybody back inside to have a cold drink and come and join us for...
Tommy, pretty disappointing start to the game. Obviously conceded a lot of opportunities, and they obviously got onto a very good run in the first half. What did you say to the players in the second half to get them to fight back the way they did?
Yeah, look, one of their major problems in the first half was our work rate. We felt that we weren't getting to the ball first. And, you know, we had a very quick side, very pacey side, but it's very hard to bring those players into the game if we're not winning the football around the 50-50 contest. So we made a special emphasis on winning the footy in the second half and using the blokes with the bigger bodies to sort of get inside, you know, feed the ball out to those guys and let them use their strengths, blokes like Chalice and Peely, you know, and Muir, really quick guys. And obviously, you know, if you create a little bit of space down forward for guys like Edmondson, they can, you know, get on the end of some, you know, quality footy.
You really got onto a good run, particularly in the last start of the last quarter. You got some momentum. You thought you were going to snatch it?
Yeah, look, it was... We found it hard to kick consecutive goals in the first half, and one of the key things was for us was to be able to kick consecutive goals. And once we sort of managed to do that in the third quarter, we thought we were a chance. We thought that, you know, we were running on top of the ground. And with having picked a very sort of quick and probably fit side, I suppose it would be, we thought that we were always going to come home with a wet sail. And must admit, look, halfway through the last quarter, we managed to draw level. We thought that, you know, we were a very, very good chance of coming out of the top of them.
Do you think the injuries to Lewis and Gergic played a role late in the game?
It was hard losing Louis so early because it affected our on-ball rotations. So we sort of had to go back to the drawing board there very early in the game. And obviously Gerg, you know, he was fantastic. He was one of our key focal points in the first half. I think may have even been our only goal kicker in the first half. To lose him was a big, I suppose it was a big hit for us to take, but we always knew that, you know, we could always find someone else to step up there, and we'll, you know, fantastic with Dougie sort of stepped up there. Edmondson kicked five in the last half.
Yeah, just tell us about that decision. Once Gerg went down, you just decided to throw him up. Obviously, he's had a bit of a run there in previous years.
Yeah, he's done it a few times with us at East Geelong when Murph's been injured or hurt, and we know we can back him in one-on-one. He's good overhead for his size, and, you know, you can always go and put a big player on him, but then, you know, because Dougie's so nimble, he can sort of, you know, get out and get on his own, and he loses him on the way back. So he tries to push up the ground pretty hard, and as you would have seen in the last quarter, and he hurts him on the way back towards the goals and gets on his own.
Yeah. All right, thanks very much.
No worries, mate.